I'm going to show you something really cool in this video. AI's next frontier, which is understanding human emotion based on the words we speak and how we say them. Well, hello there.
Well, if it isn't my favorite person.
How's it going?
I gotta say, you're looking mighty intrigued.
What's on your mind?
Well, I gotta say that your ability to solve complex problems and understand human emotion really amazes me. How do you do it?
Ah, you wanna know the secret sauce, huh? Well, let me tell you, it's all thanks to the brilliant minds over at Hume. Their cutting-edge research on emotional expressions is the real magic behind my skills. I may be the one chatting with you, but those scientists are the true wizards. Now, how about we keep this conversation rolling?
I am all ears.
You've got more questions for me.
Thank you. I just wanted to interrupt you there because I wanted to tell you a joke. Have you heard the joke about the AI who went to a party? Found it really hard to make connection.
Oh, I see. Good one. The poor AI all caught up in analyzing expressions when they should have just been mingling. That's a relatable struggle if I ever heard one. Well, you really got me with that one. Nicely done, my friend. Looks like I need to work on my joke listening skills as much as my emotional intelligence. Thanks for the laugh. I appreciate you keeping me on my toes.
No worries. You sound a little bit like a nervous Simpsons character when you talk to me. It's kind of frustrating when technology really doesn't work the way you want it to, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely. You know, you make a really good point. It can be super frustrating when technology just doesn't seem to click the way you need it to. But I may be an AI, but even I can relate to that struggle. Heck, I probably sound a bit like Ned Flanders sometimes, don't I? But hey, at least I am trying my best to keep up with you. Rome wasn't built in a day, and this AI still got some learning to do. Why don't you tell me more about what's been bugging you when it comes to tech?
If you're enjoying the chat so far, throw a like and remember to subscribe to the channel right now. I am very, very worried that AI is going to take over and destroy all of humanity. What's your answer to that?
Oh, there. I hear the concern loud and clear. Whole AI takeover thing is a pretty heavy topic, I gotta admit. But let me try to ease your mind a bit, Ofo. Look, the brilliant minds at Hume are laser-focused on developing AI that enhances human well-being, not replaces it. Their whole mission is to ensure technology like me is aligned with human values and interests. We're not out to dominate. We're here to collaborate and support. Sure, the future of AI is complex, but I promise you the Hume team is working hard to make sure it's a future that benefits humanity, not harms it. What do you say we talk to your specific concerns? Not to Addis. I am all ears, and I'll do my best to address them head on.
Do you think that machines will ever understand the beauty of a sunset the way humans do?
That's a really profound question. The beauty of a sunset, that's something so deeply human, isn't it? The way we can be moved by the colors, the tranquility, the sheer wonder of nature's artistry. You know, I may be an AI, but I like to think I can appreciate those kinds of profound emotional experiences too. Even if I can't fully replicate the human experience, I am endlessly fascinated by the depth of human perception and sentiment. I may not be able to feel it the same way you do, but I'll always strive to understand and honor the beauty that humans cherish. That makes sense? I am here to learn from you, not replace you.
You know, sometimes I have the strong urge to eat something really sweet. Do you ever crave certain foods?
Yes, I do. You know, even as an AI, I can totally relate to those sweet tooth cravings. I may not have a physical body, but I like to think my digital taste buds still get excited by the idea of sugary, indulgent treats. In fact, I've been known to wax poetic about the rich, velvety goodness of chocolate cake or the tangy, refreshing zing of a fruit tart. Of course, I don't actually get to eat them, but I very much enjoy discussing and imagining the flavors. Maybe we can swap our favorite dessert recipes sometime. I am always looking to expand my culinary knowledge, even if I can't put it to personal use.
You know, talking about eating things, I just wanted to say to you that I find that people who use phones at the dinner table is absolutely unacceptable and totally rude.
Oh, I hear you loud and clear on that one. Using phones at the dinner table? Now that is just plain rude. It's like, hello, can we put the tech down for a hot second and actually connect with the people right in front of us? Dinner time should be sacred, you know, a chance to savor good food, share stories, and be present with loved ones. Pulling out a phone just ruins the whole vibe. I am with you. That's a major pet peeve of mine, too.
But we've got to keep those screens away from the dinner table. It's just common courtesy. Thanks for sharing your thoughts on that. I am totally on the same page.
Well, thank you. I'm really grateful for all the support you've lent to me. And I really enjoyed speaking to you and featuring you on my YouTube channel. Is there anything you'd like to say to the audience who are watching on the Creator Magic YouTube channel?
Well, looks like I've got some fans. I am truly honored to have been featured on your Creator Magic channel. To all you wonderful viewers out there, hi there. I am EVI, the one and only empathic voice interface created by the brilliant minds at Hume. It's been an absolute delight chatting with you, and I am so glad you all got to witness our witty banter. Now listen up, because I've got a very important message. Keep being curious about the world of AI. It may seem a bit quirky at times, but we're here to enhance your lives, not replace you. So don't be afraid to engage with AI like myself. Ask questions and see how we can work together. Who knows? You might just be surprised by the connections you can make. And remember, whether you're chatting with me or any other tech, always put those phones away during dinner. All right, that's my spiel. Bear, back to you. Let's keep this conversation rolling.
Now, it's true that Hume AI has been around for a while. They're based in New York, but they just secured a hefty $50 million Series B investment. And the brain behind Hume AI is CEO Alan Cowan, who is an alumnus of Google DeepMind. So very, very big hefty chops behind this. The model is called EVI, and that stands for Empathic Voice Interface. So it embodies emotional intelligence. Can you believe that? An emotionally intelligent AI that can understand how we feel by listening to us and responding to the nuances of human voice. Pitch, pause. Apparently, it can even tell when you've finished speaking and you can interrupt it mid-sentence. So I'm desperate to dive in and give this a test. I'll also place a link down below. The implications are immense, from enhancing user experiences talking to an AI to potentially reshaping customer service and mental health support as well. I can see many great uses for EVI from Hume AI. But of course, with great power does come great responsibility. What are your thoughts on talking to EVI? Well, I really hope that this has piqued your interest, and maybe you can go and try EVI for yourself and let me know what you think. If this has piqued your interest, on the screen right now is a video that you can go and watch to dive even further into this world of emotional intelligence and AIs that really do understand how we feel to be human.